Welcome to Geek Philosophy, where we love geeky wisdom. If you're new to the channel, my name's Brian, and today I want to talk to you about one of my recent videos that I released using ChatGPT to write a D&D adventure. And given the popularity of that video, it got me thinking, could I use AI to help create an entire homebrew campaign setting, not just an adventure, but a whole setting? So today, I'm going to use ChatGPT-4 to create an overall setting concept and then dive deeper into the specific locations of that world. Then I'll share with you an extension that will let you save these prompts that you create and use them as templates. And you can actually add variables into them so that you can maximize the reusability of that template. But I want to set the record straight about something first. In terms of generating ideas, or to even spark your imagination, I think AI tools can be extremely useful, but I'm not suggesting that you should use them at the expense of other creators' content. You know, you can get similar or even better results from buying a published book on the topic that someone has put effort in and researched. And you've even seen me highlight some of those same resources on this channel. So I don't want you to think that I'm saying that you should use this at the expense of the material that's out there that you could go, you know, leverage yourself and purchase a book and have forever. But I also don't want you to think I'm downing AI as a whole. I think that there are good uses for it and it should be used as a tool, again, not at the expense of some other creator's content. So, and either way, I don't think there is anything that can replace our imaginations. That's one of the things that I like about role-playing games, right? We have our own imaginations building the game as we play it. Just wanted to be clear and on the record about that. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to ask ChatGPT to help create an overall setting, but I need a basic prompt to do that. So I want to put together a structured prompt that's designed to guide ChatGPT to create the basic underlying elements of the new campaign setting. So I've put one together and each category focuses on a different aspect of the world. Now I'm going to be copy and pasting to make this video a little tighter. So check the description for a link to the Google Doc where I have this exact prompt and the other ones that I'm going to be using today. My initial prompt may look something like, I'm working on a setting for my tabletop role-playing game. Please generate a tabletop role-playing game setting with the following components. And then I'm going to list all of the different categories of information I want it to generate for me. I'm going to start with the game that I'm playing, the game system. I'm using 5e D&D. It's what I play the most, but, you know, use whatever you'd like. Then I want it to generate a name for that setting that's based on all of the other information that it comes up with. I want a setting theme, the overarching idea for the setting as a whole, the atmosphere of the campaign world. I want to understand what the cultures and races and species and all that kind of stuff are. And I want ChatGPT to describe the primary cultures that exist there. Then I want to define the level of magic and or technology. So, you know, is it common or uncommon? And the level of magic and technology has a big impact in the world as a whole. Then the basics, the geographical features and how that might impact the world in travel and trade between organizations. Then the government system, I want to make sure that it generates something for that for me, and a little bit of history of the world. So based on everything that we've got so far, hey, come up with some world history. Then the dangers and threats, I want to make sure that they're listing some things that the adventurers would likely face in the world and some challenges that they would have to overcome. Religion and beliefs, the main belief systems of the world. I also want to have the laws and the norms and what are the acceptable social behavior here. Then finally, I want it to say, hey, what are five key places of interest? What are five focal points for this setting? Okay, so I am in ChatGPT-4. I'm going to go ahead and paste in the prompt that we just talked about so that I can start generating, well, ChatGPT can start generating an overview of what this setting is all going to be about. And this is going to be the Verdant Nexus, a nexus of worlds. Interestingly enough, when I was a kid, I created a campaign world just by pure happenstance called Nexus, which is really interesting, and it kind of flows a little bit like this. But at any rate, here we go, and I'm going to keep this one. I could just regenerate another one, but I think it's great that we've got Nexus as the name, you know, a flashback to me in elementary and middle school. So here is this overview of the setting. I could ask follow-up questions. I could tell it to adjust certain things and refine things further. Do whatever you'd like for your setting. I could even just run the prompt again and start from scratch just to see if I like that better as a whole. To be fair, this gives me something that I can use as a game master. It's not really player-friendly information, so I'm also going to ask ChatGPT to take this information that it just produced and produce a synopsis, something that I could use for the players. And for that prompt, I might ask ChatGPT something like this. Based on the setting of, and you insert your setting name, generate a campaign teaser that introduces potential players to the new world. This teaser should touch on the unique features of the setting, hint at the kind of adventures that await, and provide a taste of the overarching story or conflicts. Okay, now I've got this setting, and I'm going to go ahead and use my prompt for the synopsis. I'm going to go up to the top here and copy in the Verdant Nexus of Worlds as my campaign setting name, and then use this. After I paste it in, I'm going to use this to generate the synopsis. Now, this synopsis is something that I can use for my players. It says everything that I need it to say about the campaign world in a way that doesn't dive in too deep, but gives it enough to really be a campaign teaser, so to speak, of what the world is all about. It doesn't talk specifically about the adventures that we're going to have, but it will give an overview of the types of adventures we could have, right? So I really like having this available. This is a great start. I've got all of the details broken out and then a synopsis here. But that's just the start, right? It's just the basis. From there, I want to expand on specific locations in the setting. I'll write a location generator prompt to provide additional details for each of those five places of interest. You can use whatever you like here, like I said, but this is just an example to get you started. So I would start with location name, put the name in of the one that we're picking, the geography, what's there, what's the geography like for that particular area? Then what's the purpose or function of that particular location? Is it, you know, a religious hub, a trade route, a pilgrimage site? Is it a military location? Or maybe it's just a farming community, whatever. Then we need to decide on the population. So this should be generating some details based on the information that we've got so far and the information of the setting that we've provided, along with the local government. We may have decided what the overarching government structure is for the campaign world, but how do they handle things in this area? Then also, I think history for that individual location is important, so they can write about the significant events in the past. I say they as if it's ChatGPT, you know, maybe I've already convinced that it's going to be talking back to me anyway. Then things like the economy and resources and things like that, the infrastructure, marketplaces and temples and all kinds of things. One of the big things, NPCs. This gives us a start of the notable NPCs that reside at this location. It doesn't have to flesh everything out here, it just gives them sort of some personalities and goals and connection to the location itself. And then specific locations within that area. So if this is a city, I want to make sure that, you know, we've got all the businesses and the town halls and all those things covered. This may be redundant, but I figure adding it in here again makes sure that we're getting that. In addition, I want to know a little bit about the local culture. You know, maybe there are some festivals that are happening. Conflicts. Are there any ongoing struggles within that area or at that location? Maybe there are political rivalries going on, or, you know, threats from other neighboring places. Maybe there's a war happening. I don't know. One of the key things here is quest plot hooks. This is a chance for hooks into the area and developing the surrounding area. Describe the relationship between this smaller chunk of the world and the world around it. All right, we're going to continue by generating one of the locations that was generated. So I'm going to scroll back up after I've pasted in what I just talked about with you about the prompt itself. And then I'm going to enter in a name for this location. So we have a bunch that were provided for us up here. So let's go ahead and do Heart of the Nexus and use that as the first location I want it to develop for me. So I'll enter that in. Everything else is there. We're telling it to use the overview and the synopsis. And so here we go. It's going to start generating a deeper dive into the Heart of the Nexus. Great. And so we've got the geography and the purpose and all of the things that we've outlined are being generated here. Now, I can adapt this again, just like I mentioned, we can change this however we'd like, and this will become even more specific to my campaign world. This is more of an overview, right? This isn't giving us every detail. It's not generating a map for us. It's not doing everything, but it's giving us an overview that we can really dig into. I feel that when you're generating a campaign world for your home campaign, most of it should be done while you're playing. You do a basis for things. You have the groundwork laid out. Let the game create the world. Let the players be a part of the world building along with you. So this is a great opportunity to use this as a tool to help spark the imagination and move forward with generating the areas that you're going to be playing in. And there you go. We've got our first location ready. Again, adjust it, expand it, do whatever you need. But remember, the gameplay, what you do at the table, will flesh this out even more. But what about future locations? I don't want to have to go through this every single time. I want to make it convenient and easy to come up with a new location based on what we've got. I use an extension for Google Chrome called PromptGenius. I'm not the only one to do this. I'll link to a video that goes into this in a little bit more detail, but let me show you how to do that. We're going to actually go to the Chrome Web Store, and then we're going to search for PromptGenius. And PromptGenius is the extension for Google Chrome that we're going to add, and this will allow us to do all those things that we were hoping to do. So it's going to pop up, tell us over here that it is installed. It'll give us a place so we can actually go from here, but where I want to go back over to ChatGPT and refresh, and then you will see that, yep, it's been installed. You'll see this information right here front and center, and then on the right of the screen is where you're going to actually have the prompts that you save. We're going to use new prompt. All right, we're going to call this one our location generator. And I'm gonna paste in the entire information that we already discussed before. I'm gonna have this in that doc like I mentioned, but let's go through it just so you can see. Given the information contained in the campaign setting overview and campaign setting synopsis, please provide a location with the following location parameters. Please expand as appropriate. I want them to be able to expand on anything they're working on. You'll notice that this is the same, so the campaign setting overview is the one that was generated from the prompt that we made. Then the campaign setting synopsis was the same one that was generated, Verdant Nexus, Nexus of Worlds. We can rename that if we'd like, but here's all the information that was already there. And then location parameters is our location prompt. Here's the difference so far. I've replaced location name with location in brackets. What this is doing is making it a variable. That means when I run the prompt, it's going to ask me to input a location name, and then everything else in here is already saved for me. I'm just giving it a name and running the prompt. You could adjust things if you need to, but the purpose here is to have something saved as a template. You could also use as many variables as you want. I'm only using it for location name here, but maybe you want to put in a variable for the government so that the government changes every time. Maybe you want to change the economy every time. Maybe you want to change the culture every time. Do whatever you want. You can put in the variables based on the information that you want to change with each time you run the prompt. Tags are so that you can make this organized. You can enter in as many tags as you like. You just type it in, you separate with a comma, you don't have to use any spaces, and this is for your organization. The one thing that isn't optional though is the category. You have to pick a category. This is baked into PromptGenius. I'm gonna use other. The reason there are categories, by the way, is because you can submit this prompt so that others can use these prompts as well. So if you wanna build a community around the prompts you're using, go for it. I'm gonna save. Now I'm going to refresh, and you'll see that it shows up. And because this is a very long prompt, it makes it very unwieldy, and they thought of this already. So the compact view checkbox is great because it just takes it down to the title, and then you can use it from there. So you'll see, I can click that, and what is it doing? It's telling me to enter a location. And I'm gonna use the second one that was generated, the Gith Stronghold, and submit, and you'll see that it enters into our chat box at the bottom. You do have to type something in so it recognizes that you're typing. I just hit a space, and then the send message will appear. And here we go, we're off to the races. It is generating a location for our setting. Now, I can do this as many times as I like. I can swap out that location name. You can see how this will be very powerful if you change the variables or even the type of prompt, right? Like, think of this as a format that you can use for all kinds of things. And here we are, we've got a location that has been generated based on the prompt that we have just entered. And if we want to do this again, we could either hit the regenerate response, or we could refresh, hit the button, enter a name, and this time I'll just make one up. Here it is, down at the bottom, just checking it. Everything's there. Hit enter. And now we are off again, creating a new location. This time it's Coppergate. And so we've got a very good tool that we can use to generate content for our own home games. And because it's saved as a template, you know you're being consistent with your input, so the outputs should be fairly consistent as well. Again, just a tool in the toolbox for us game masters that like to move quick and get things rolling. So it's really more of a technique than anything. You can do all sorts of prompts. You can use these variables in there to help you save time. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe, and don't forget to turn on the notifications and all that stuff so you don't miss an update. It really, really helps the channel. All right. Today, I'm going to leave you with some geek philosophy from William H. Glass. True alchemists do not change lead into gold. They change the world into words. Cheers.